Batman's origin story has been told many times in a whole slew of live-action movies and TV shows, in addition to all the animated versions, but how is each version of the murder of Thomas and Martha Wayne different? Even though Bruce Wayne's origin story is pretty much common knowledge, each new live-action version of the Caped Crusader has their own version of the Wayne murders. I'm Greg Elliott with Screen Rant, and just taking into account the film and TV adaptations, here's every version of the Wayne murder scene and how Bruce's origin changes in each one. The first time we saw the Waynes get gunned down on screen was in the original 1989 Batman. The scene begins typically with the Wayne family exiting a movie theater and making their way home down the dark and dangerous streets of Gotham City. But then we get our first deviation from the comics. Instead of just the mugger Joe Chill, this time around it's him and a young Jack Napier, the film's Joker, and Jack is the one that actually pulls the trigger. When Joel Schumacher took over the franchise from Tim Burton for 1995's Batman Forever, that of course meant that we had to see Bruce's parents die again. Batman Forever's Wayne murders are a lot less detailed compared to some of the other live-action flashbacks. They do have that same ethereal feel as Burton's, with lots of slow motion and audio reverb, and this time around a heavy blue tint to make it feel even more cold and distant. We wouldn't be subjected to seeing the poor Waynes get murdered again until the Christopher Nolan Christian Bale era. I mean, when the movie's called Batman Begins, you do kinda have to show how Batman began, right? Batman Begins was known for its fresh, realistic take on Batman, and this version does away with the hazy, dreamlike style of previous incarnations, presenting it just like any other real-life scene in the movie. This time, the Waynes are coming out of the opera instead of a movie theater, Joe Chill is no longer a well-dressed gangster but a twitchy, spun-out thug, and Thomas gets shot when he moves a little too abruptly to shield his wife. He's also able to get out a few last words to Bruce this time, rather than just dying silently in the street. Zack Snyder does love his slow-mo, and so we go back to a lot of that in Batman v Superman's opening credits. But the biggest difference here is that Thomas Wayne actually tries to fight back against Joe Chill, but is shot before he's able to land a punch. Martha actually has some fight in her too, but the only good that does is give us a super dramatic shot of the gun slide shattering her pearl necklace. How artsy! The scene ends with Thomas's dying word being Martha, which of course sets up the moment when Bruce and Clark go from being mortal enemies to best pals in the film's final act. Since the Gotham TV show actually begins with the death of the Waynes, the series doesn't depict it as a flashback at all, and this version is surprisingly more bloody than most. Two big changes in this one are that Selina Kyle actually witnessed the whole thing, and it wasn't Joe Chill who killed them, but Matches Malone, who was contracted by the lady after Hugo Strange put out a hit on the Waynes. Which brings us to Joker. This time, their deaths come about as a direct result of the class struggle between the rich and poor of Gotham, and the Waynes were specifically targeted because of their supposed part in it all. It's not even about money or pearls this time. Thomas and Martha are executed on the spot, leaving young Bruce standing there with his mom's blood all over his face. So, like 1989's Batman, Joker is once again responsible for the death of the Waynes, albeit in a very different way. We don't think we really ever need to see the Waynes get killed again, we get it by now, but it's probably not the last time, and we wouldn't be surprised if the Batman reminds us once again how Bruce was inspired to don the cowl and clean up the streets of Gotham. But which version do you think was best? Let us know in the comments, and keep coming back to Screen Rant for more on the world's greatest detective. I'm Greg Elliott, and I'll see you next time.